villages of Sabah and Sarawak have often been neglected, forgotten, and brushed aside. That is what I'm trying to bring up today. I wish to set the record straight. That in particular, in respect of the rights of MP from Sabah and Sarawak, we are entitled to use the English language in this house. I wish to.
Dia kena izin speaker ya.
Mr. Speaker.
Yeah.
There is the difference. Dengan
saya
izin ada as
hari,
of rights.
Dengan penampang izin, menggunakan bahasa Inggeris dengan izin speaker. Tetapi pada ketika itu juga speaker beritahu, dia kata dia tidak ingin dijadikan itu sebagai kebiasaan di dewan.
Mr. Chairman.
Yeah.
Mr. Chairman. The use of English is guaranteed under Article 161.
Tapi kita ada peraturan mesyuarat dengan izin
Article
speaker,
161.
Dengan izin speaker dalam dewan.
Dengan izin. Under Article is 161. No 161 bracket 1. No act of parliament terminating or restricting the use of the English language for any purpose mentioned in closest bracket 2 to bracket 5 of
articles. Saya yakin yang muat boleh berucap dalam bahasa Malaysia.
Ini. No, it is a different matter. It's not whether I can speak in bahasa or I cannot speak in bahasa.
I can also speak
Malaysia.
In English.
But the whole thing is that this is our rights here. Mr. Speaker, Mr. Chairman, you're from Sarawak, Sabah.
Saya tahu, tetapi speaker hari itu bagi keputusan bahwa dia tidak inginkan itu jadi kebiasaan.
We should not unnecessarily restrict our right as guaranteed under the constitution. Subclause, there is a specific reference in the constitution to the use of English language in either House of Parliament by a member for or from the state of Sabah and Sarawak. What you want, Bintulu? What you want?
Hello.
I'm speaking on behalf of Sarawak.
You can take
Sarawak's right. Do not unnecessarily surrender your right. You are compromising our own stand. You are from Sarawak.
Exactly, you are Sarawak.
Listen to him first. Yeah, Brahma Pandak Kuching.
Yes.
Why we want to fight our unnecessary thing?
This is not
ini
unnecessary. That's why I say, over the years,
hey, this is not right. This is our right. Come on,
this is our right. No act of parliament restricting.
We fight something more meaningful for
the use of English language.
Why we want to fight for the Taiwan punya masa? Lawan-lawan betul, iyalah.
What do you mean, lawan-lawan betul? This is our fundamental rights under the constitution. Even though I'm not talking about that.
Listen to
you
first.
Why we always want to mislead the people?
What do you mean by mislead the people? What do you mean by mislead the people? No. Let me.
This is upholding our right. Sit down,
Yang Muhammad, dalam peraturan masyarakat perlu izin speaker.
Mr. Chairman.
Perlu izin speaker, Yang Muhammad. Hari itu penampang berucap, speaker buat keputusan bahwa dia tidak harus jadikan kebiasaan dan izinkan penampang pada ketika itu menggunakan bahasa Inggeris.
Yes. Yeah. After that, I make further research on the provision of the constitution. It states there, no act of parliament terminating or restricting the use of language, English language for any purpose mentioned in clause blah blah blah, and it shall come into operation as regards the use of English language in any case mentioned in clause 2 of this article until
frame.
10 years after
time frame,
10 years
there
after, yes, after Malaysia Day. Yeah. Mr. Speaker, hear me out. Until today, I will go in 161 close sub close bracket 2 A to the use of English language in either House of Parliament by a member for or from the state of Sabah and Sarawak. Okay, that is the provision. So far, there is no Act of Parliament passed that I know of to restrict members of Parliament from Sabah and Sarawak to use English language in this House. No such Act. The closest you can find is the National Language Act. The National Language Act. But mind you, Mr. Speaker, in the National Language Act, close to close
one. I would allow you go straight to the butiran. Ya,
yes, butiran, you. Pengurusan Dewan.
Yeah.
How this Dewan is to be run?
Yeah.
Speak English. This is our rights. The act about National Language Act. This act shall come into force in the states of Sabah and Sarawak on such dates as the respective state authorities may, by enactment of the legislature of the respective states, appoint or different dates may be appointed for the coming into force of different provisions of this act in those states. Mr. Speaker, as far as Sarawak is concerned, there's no legislation passed in the state assembly for National Language Act to come into operation. Therefore, as far as Sarawak is concerned, the National Language Act is not effective or is not operative. And by extension, member of parliament from Sabah and Sarawak are entitled to speak English in this house. And as of right, not dengan izin. Bintulu doesn't understand. It's a shame that he stands out to object to it when I'm speaking on Sarawak's right.
Tahun 99 saya baru pertama masuk sini, itu masa Duang yang dipetua, Tun yang dipetua sudah bagi tahu dalam Tewang ini kuna bahasa Malaysia. Kalau mau kuna bahasa Inggeris, mesti mau dengar izin daripada speaker. You tak dengar lagi kah?
Whatever.
Sudah setuju itu masa.
The speaker, he's making a point.
Member of Parliament from Sarawak and Sabah to speak, to use the English language in this house. Otherwise, Sarawak MPs are entitled as of rights to speak English in this house.
Yang berhormat memperjuangkan
wakil rakyat to respect.
Boleh mencela.
The founders, the drafter of the constitution.
Hey.
We have to respect the meaning of this constitution.
Kita ni wakil rakyat.
You sit down.
Rakyat di negeri Sabah semua bukan paham English. Luar bandar.
Stand together.
Rakyat
di Sarawak
mendengar. Ujap-ujap di parlemen.
To protect what we have in this constitution.
Putatan, senakan, duduk. Duduk ah, ya.
Mr. Speaker.
Ya, you can gulung okay, yang Muhammad. Tak ada masalah. Ha? Habis masalah.
Saya okay, nak ni. Pencelahan. Boleh.
Tak ada, habis masalah dah Muhammad.
Mr. Chairman.
Okey, terima kasih. Terima kasih. Saya rasa saya ingin tanya kepada Kuching tentang penggunaan bahasa Inggeris ini. Apa yang jelas perlembagaan dan undang-undang tertinggi dalam artikel 62 yang selalu dikatakan oleh Tuan Yang Pertua Speaker bahawa apa ni peraturan mesyuarat ni dibuat berdasarkan perlembagaan. So peraturan mesyuarat ya, tidak boleh mengatasi perlembagaan. Jadi
dia
saya
tidak immaterial at this stage. Ya. Saya bagi kebenaran
untuk berucap. Saya rasa pihak Bahasa
Tetapi
Nasional ini
pada masa yang sama kita akan kaji balik one history untuk dibaca bersama dengan peraturan mesyuarat.
Kita bisa diklarifikasi.
But for the time being, I allow him. Yeah, that's it.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, for allowing me to use English language. And I hope after much research, you will concur with what I've said today and shut the mouth of those who objected. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Masih. Habis dah.
Datuk Pengurusi.
Dah habis dah.
Ini mana boleh
kucing dah habis.
Ini tidak jaga peraturan.